say thank you to this special person that doesn't want to be mentioned the name, but he helped us to transliterate our books into English. So
our extract of the
some of the extracts that we're gonna read today were transliterated by him, but he didn't want to be mentioned. So thank you for that, guy.
Not more than that.
Perhaps there was no occasion to speak. Perhaps I was just too shy and reserved to speak to him. Angel also did not initiate to speak to me. I never knew why. He had this moderate stature compared to other Indonesians. And his iconic center parting hairdo was also a common feature of our peers. His Palembang ancestry endowed him with fair complexion. He was physically very attractive to me. Erika was my accomplice during our second year in school. Whenever the bell rang for recess, we would scamper out of class, rush down the corridor, and then walk as slowly as we could as we passed Erika's classroom. Each step mattered as I glanced through the gaps in the window, hoping to make eye contact. I prayed that the moment would freeze so that he could see me and share a glance. And when our gaze met, I wished it lasted longer. I was his secret admirer. The crossroads and the bright lights. I saw my shadow skirting the surface of the deep blue waters, seeking to find my definition of life and shaping my identity. I grew closer to the spirit of this island that was constantly seeking to achieve higher dreams and aspirations. The island is synonymous with its lion statue, tenacious people. And as the waves rolled to shore, I felt the warm breeze across my face and the occasional flutter of seagulls. They perched nearby, looking on curiously at my gaze face. While my mind wandered surrounded by millions of stars, I realized that I was not alone. I shared the spirit of adventure with three others. And at no point did I lose my faith of direction. All by the grace of God. From the bow of the sailboat, I eventually caught sight of land. A sight to disembark and place my feet firmly rooted to the ground. It was time to part and go our separate ways. I waved enthusiastically as everyone disappeared into the distance. I wanted our path to cross again. The hypothesis of a young woman in Fukuoka Airport. I'm a young woman, and that is simple and significant reality. My feet lay bare on sand, but they could support the weight of my dreams. My dreams are that of every other woman alive. No matter how hard or heavy the burden, I could let them rest on my shoulders. No matter how far the sky was, it was reachable. I deserve whatever burden or challenges from God, and I know and I'm capable of resolving them. From that day, when I looked in the mirror, I did not see a lonely woman in a distant land. I saw a winner in myself. I had to be strong. I had to be resilient. I could only count on myself. Hence, I had to work hard. Women are never weak. They are the foundation of life and are stable in the face of pressure, just like the coral reef resists the oceans. I had no doubt that it was the truth. And when faced with people who doubted me, all I could do was to work harder and be better and prove my worth. Women, and only women, could prove that women are equally capable.
Malam-malam terang, baik Tasnim Fauzia Rais and Rido Rahmayati.